Welcome to this week's cybersecurity awareness video. Today, we will be discussing the dangers of email phishing and how to protect yourself from these cyber attacks. The term phishing refers to almost any kind of email-based cyber attack. Cyber criminals will try to attack you by sending you an email pretending to be a trusted source. These attacks work one of four ways. Harvesting information. The attacker's objective is to fool you into providing your login, password, or credit card number. Infecting your computer with malicious links. The cyber attacker's goal here is to infect your computer once you have clicked on a link. Infecting your computer with malicious attachments. The hacker wishes to gain complete control of your computer once you have opened up an infected file attachment. Scams. The cyber attacker is after your money and personal information. Don't be fooled by these criminals. Let's see how well Stony Brook students know how to protect themselves from phishing. Do you ever look for mistakes in emails that you receive from businesses?
I do, yes, because I'm a Virgo and I'm a perfectionist and I notice like little things that nobody else notices, so.
No, I do not.
I find them pretty often, but I don't really actively look for them.
How do you open links that are emailed or messaged to you?
If I know it's a safe link, like then I'll open it. But sometimes, if it seems sketchy, I won't open it. Like if it's for a job that I know I never applied for, I'm not gonna open it.
I click on it, and if I have to download it, I won't click on it. I'll just go on another computer and do it because I never have room on my laptop.
Depends on the link. I usually just click it, let it open up in the window if I trust it. If it looks like bull, I just skip over it.
What do you do when you receive an odd or too good to be true email from a friend or one of your contacts?
Years ago, I used to open them and be like, what? But now, I know better because, first of all, my friends don't even email me. Unless, if they tell me they're about to email me something, if it's for class, then I'll open it. But it's my friends text me. They don't email me. So I know it's a scam.
That's a hard question. I get overly excited, and then I just get excited.
No, just ignore it.
Ignore it.
I usually just ignore it.
Do you ever check to see how emails are addressing you? What do you look for?
Sometimes they say, Chris with an exclamation point. I'm like, no, nobody does that. That's not one of them. No one even says my name. They just the message.
It depends. If it's from a business, I look to see, if they spell my name right. That's one. Or if it seems, authentic. I don't know.
If I'm being addressed as, a student, then that's something to look out for because it's obviously important. But if it's just a really casual message, then, I ignore it.
If you think that you are reading an email that sounds odd or too good to be true, and suspect that you are under a phishing attack or scam, you can protect yourself by simply deleting the email. Remember, be aware and on the lookout for suspicious emails that are not directly addressing you, emails that sound odd or too good to be true, do not click on links, copy and paste them, or type the destination into your browser. And remember to look for spelling mistakes in emails from businesses. They usually proofread them before sending them out.